Right Honourable Prime Minister, Sri Pushpa Kamal Dahal, President of Nepali Congress and former Prime Minister, Honourable Sir Bahadur Deewadi, Chairman of UML and former Prime Minister, Honourable K.P. Sharma Oliji, Honourable Deputy Prime Minister and Finance Minister, former Finance Minister, Honourable Ministers, and the President of the Asian Infrastructure Bank, Honourable Ministers, Excellencies, Distinguished Guests, Friends of Press, Ladies and Gentlemen. It gives me immense pleasure welcoming you to the Nepal Investment Summit 2017. Thank you, Honourable Prime Minister. Thank you, Sir Bahadur Deewadi. Thank you, K.P. Oliji, and all of who are present here. I would like to thank you for gracing the event and our special guest, Honourable Finance Minister of India, Sri Arun Jaitley, who will join us in the afternoon, and President of Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank, Mr. Jin Liquid, for taking your precious time and honouring us with the presence. On behalf of the government and citizens of Nepal, I welcome our distinguished guests at the inauguration of the Nepal Investment Summit. I especially welcome our foreign guests who have taken time from their busy schedule and are here for this summit. I express our heartfelt gratitude for your gracious presence. In my role as Minister of Industry, the one lesson I have drawn deep into my heart, it is this: Nepal needs to create jobs for millions of young and eager men and women, and that the act of creating, nurturing and growing industries, both small and large, is the most proven way to generate jobs. But that need help millions of our fellow citizens to not only survive, but also thrive as human beings who can make full use of their potential. Here I recall the idea of our leader of democratic movement, late B.P. Koirala, the first elected Prime Minister of Nepal, that prosperity of citizens has its own when the nation itself prospers. I'm in politics and became an activist since early age because I see it as a means to enable millions of people to share fruits of prosperity, and I am fully engaged in this goal of translating the potential. For all this to happen, we need investments, not only funds, but more importantly, the know-how, the contacts, and the connections to the global market where the customers are made in Nepal, goods and services are sold for. Ladies and gentlemen, in the last 2.5 decades or so, despite our political and other associated challenges, we have significantly raised the life expectancy of our citizens. We have drastically lowered the infant mortality rate. More Nepali children go to school than at any time in our history. We have lowered our annual rate of population growth. We have a generation of young and eager to learn Nepalese who want to have fulfilling and productive work for a better future, for themselves, for their society, and for their country. Indeed, in many ways today, ours is a healthier, more educated, and more aware country than any time in our history. Committed, dedicated, and partnership Nepal is what you get in Nepal of 2017. Yes, there are challenges. Yes, there are difficulties. But our people's ambitions and aspirations have risen to such a degree that we as politicians realize the fact and are committed to do our best to serve the people's aspirations for the better life. We have already initiated the second generation of reforms to make it more growth and investment friendly so that we can realize our mission and the aspirations of the people. Respected guests, we have made considerable and historic progress in the political front with promulgation of a new constitution, enshrining the democratic principles of the country that has ushered us into a more stable environment. There is broad agreement among the political parties that the phase of transition, political change is over, and now our prime focus is on the economic transformation. Last year, I campaigned to open up a few previously sub companies and succeeded in reopening the companies that has long been dead, not because they produced inferior products or lack a market, but because they lack good management, were hosting the summit with similar will and determination. Dear respected friends, there are business opportunities here in which global capital can be deployed to unlock the market and to spread prosperity. To that end, Nepal wants funds, know-how and collaboration, and in return, Nepal is prepared to give you opportunities that are at the frontier in tourism, in infrastructure, in hydro, in public services, such as transport, healthcare, education, in mining. The possibilities are long. Nepal is open for business harnessing. Here I recall the idea of the commander of the People's Movement of 1990, late Goddess Man Singh, who envisioned economic revolution as succession to political revolution. This guides me to go further. All leading political parties, be they in government or in the opposition, do agree that ensuring prosperity to the people of Nepal should be the primary focus of the further political discourse of Nepal. The very fact that all top leaders of the major political parties have joined in this summit, it is testimony to it. Using this platform, I express my gratitude for sending such a strong signal of political commitment of the nation. I can safely say that whatever we do for promoting investment is backed by the commitment of the political leaders, government of Nepal, and will of the people of the nation as last. For me, investment should be a win-win partnership of investor and the host country. The investor should be able to get return in proportion of the risk taken. Nepal offers numerous lucrative sectors and projects for investment. Obviously, water and energy-related projects, infrastructure-based projects, high-value, low-volume agriculture-related projects, tourism, including destination development and promotion, health and education, projects oriented towards exports, mines and minerals come to the fore whenever we talk of areas of competitive advantage of Nepal. Nepal is ready for investment. We are working with various stakeholders to provide a conducive atmosphere to come and to do business, to expedite the approval process for FDI. As the chairman of the Industrial Promotion Board, I please that there will be no backlog and delays in the investment process. Yesterday only we passed the FDI amounting around 30 million rupees. In terms of policies and laws, Nepal is perhaps one of the most open economies in the region. We allow 100% foreign ownership in most of the sectors. Our tax rates are lower than most of the countries in South Asia. The government is receptive to the constructive ideas coming from the investors. The reforms in our system and procedures are ongoing. Since the government took office, we have been able to complete the process of enactment of Industrial Enterprise Act, Special Economic Zones Act. The company law is in the final stage in the parliament, which is expected to make the exit easier and faster. The law governing foreign investment is being improved to accommodate more reforms. We provide an equivocal guarantee that the investment will not be expropriated and will treat the industry owned by foreign investors at par with those owned by our own nationals. We allow investors to take their profits and capital back in the same currency as they have brought investment. The policy and legal framework governing entry, operation and exit of investment in Nepal will be dealt in greater length in our consequent sessions. Nepalese have made name and fame in history for their bravery, simplicity, endurance and honesty. These are attributes which come handy not only in fighting wars but also in running factories and workplaces. Today I welcome you to the land of Himalayas, the land of peace, birthplace of Lord Buddha and a culture so diverse and rich in history that one needs to seek to believe. I call on my foreign participants not to be confined to your hotel room only, but call on you to venture out and visit places, if possible, outside of Kathmandu too. I would like to put on record our appreciation to all the political parties as well. These are sent a clear signal to the potential investors that Nepal is truly ready for business. Let us give one another a chance, finalists, to work together to match demand and supply, to push for workable governance and management models so that the funds, expertise, contacts, and collaboration flow between us. Nepal's industry and Nepal's people will benefit together with global investors. Within 10 years, let the situation prevail where no Nepali citizen would have to go abroad in search of job. For me, making investment happen, the summit happen, is a continuous process. This summit is only our beginning. In this mission of building a prosperous Nepal, your gracious presence and participation has indeed made it history. For Nepal, it is truly a historic moment, and I am pleased to welcome you on board at this epoch-making event. I once again welcome you all and expect fruitful discussions in the ensuing session. May I wish a very pleasant and fruitful stay here in Nepal, all of our guests, for all of our guests. And I also extend sincere thanks for your admirable and highly encouraging participation. Thank you, everyone. Thanks. We'll be right back.